Everybody, this is my practice drawing. You already know what it is. This is Bob Ross in MS Paint. You already know, let's go.
Hi, welcome back. Certainly glad you could join me today. Today I have one of my little friends with me. This is a little baby cedar waxwing. He's just probably 12, 14 days old. Maybe a little older than that, but not very old. And he's just as precious as he could be. I thought I'd bring him on today and share him with you. Hi, guy. How are you? Can you talk a little bit? Can you talk a little bit? Talk a little bit? What? What? Yeah, I know. Yeah. But he's something else. Tell you what, let's have him run all the colors across the screen that you need to paint along with us today.
And practice.
While you're doing that,
oh, titanium white, phthalo, green and blue, classic, Prussian blue, classic, midnight classic.
By 24 inch canvas, and I've taken a little masking tape that I picked up here in the studio, and I've just sort of put some masking tape around the edges. I thought we'd do something a little different, where we take maybe, let's paint a scene that goes through these two sections, and maybe it'll start out as summer and end up as winter over here. Just to break it up, and different. It'll give you a lot of good practice. So let's have the summer scene on the left. So I'll start with phthalo blue, a little bit of phthalo blue on the 2-inch brush.
This looks like phthalo blue.
And we'll drop in just a happy little sky. Just a simple little thing. Just making little crisscrosses, little X's. Summer skies are normally a lot brighter than winter skies. Winter we get sort of gloomy and drab. And we'll put a little water. We'll have water. There. I like it. All right. Then we'll come back and we'll blend all that out in a minute. But right now, that's good enough. That's good enough. All right. On the other side, it's going to be winter.
I'm perfect.
Gonna Prussian blue. It's much darker. There. It'll make it look colder. Ooh, rough. There. Something about like that. You can even add a little touch of the midnight black to it if you want to really gray it down. See there?
Oh shoot, I did it wrong.
Take the same color, impression blue, a little touch of the black in it. And we'll just put in a little water indication. Just pulling straight across. It's that simple.
There we go.
That simple. Now then. Let me grab another brush here. I have several of them going. Maybe over here in the summer side. Hey, sounds like a new series, Summerside. Maybe there's a happy little cloud or two over in the sky. We'll just take a little titanium white, a 2-inch brush, and we'll just put an indication. I don't want to get too carried away today. Just a little indication.
This was a mistake, wasn't it?
Happy little clouds that live up here. Little fluffy clouds up here in the summer. Now, over here on the winter, maybe there's just a long stringy cloud. Something a lot like that. It comes across. That's about all you have to do. The little stringy clouds are easy. We'll make another one. It's so much fun. But that'll give the indication of a little cloud that lives right there. All right. All right. The fun part of this is washing the brush. Let's do that. We wash the brushes.
Hold on.
With odorless paint thinner.
There. Beat the devil out of it. I don't know what that sounded like to you.
Right. Let's do a happy little mountain.
Ooh.
Take some black, Prussian blue, get some crimson, maybe a little Van Dyke brown. Doesn't matter, whatever. Pull it out as flat as you can get it. Take the knife, cut across, get a little roll of paint. It lives right on the edge of the knife. Let's go up in here. And maybe, there we are. Maybe there's a mountain that lives right here. Wasn't that little bird cute? Cedar waxwing. I borrowed him. And the bird lady here in Muncie, Indiana, where we film. And her name is Diana Schaefer. And Diana devotes just about her entire life to taking care of these little creatures. Fantastic that people care enough.
I'm trying, guys.
The time and the resources to doing these kind of things. My hat's off to her. There.
I'm just trying what works.
I wasn't careful. I could become just like Diane. I could become so infatuated with these little rascals that I'd spend most of my time just working with them. And there's a lot of people like Diane all over the country Nearly every town has a bird lady or someone who takes care of injured and orphaned little creatures. And you need to, if you have time, go out and see them. They've got interesting things, they need your support. And they're super people. Just taking your 2-inch brush, pulling it. I want to blend that color out. Because if you can see the entire mountain, it's always more distinct at the top than it is at the bottom.
Perfect.
Will do that to it automatically.
Oh, shoot. Once more.
Yeah. We will take some titanium white, pull it out very, very flat. Once again, take the knife, go in, cut. We'll need that little roll of paint. Get in the habit of loading a knife like that. It'll save you a lot of agony. Touch, no pressure, no pressure, no pressure. No pressure at all. No pressure at all. Just let it glide across there.
I can't do that.
That easy. Maybe this one. You have to make decisions here. Maybe this one comes out. Here. I don't know. I don't know. It's up to you. Can bring them together if you want to?
There we go.
Totally and completely up to you.
I like it.
No, we don't want to stop there. This side to have a little highlight on.
This is going to be long.
So you probably have more sunlight.
I don't know who's editing this, or if I'm going to edit it at all. Jackson, if you're editing this, just cut out all the shit.
Various colors of brown and stuff to make different mountain shapes. And that works. Works just the same. Take a little blue, a little white. Pull it out flat. Once again, a little roll of paint. And with that, we can go back up in here. And we'll put the indication of some little shadows. Pay particular attention to angles, mountains, or just geometric shapes. Once again, angles. Notice that most of your shadow angles go in one direction, most of your highlight angles go in an opposing or opposite direction. And that's basically all there is to it. No pressure. Absolutely no pressure. Can't say that enough times. I get letters every day from people saying, mountains just don't work right. What's happening? It's normally one of two things. Most common is people try to do it with a paint that's thin. You absolutely must have a very firm, dry paint. That is, it's essential. Without it, you're just going to become a mud mixer. You need a firm, dry paint. That's the only way you can paint over the top of this over and over and over. See, now you can come back in here. You can change your mind. Sorry, you keep jumping around. There. Okay. Maybe you can get crazy and maybe put a whole nother projection here. It's up to you. Just see these things in your mind and drop them in there. No big deal. You have total control of it, total power. You can do anything. Just wipe the knife off. Just put any old shape you want there, wherever. I'm going to quit. I'm going to fill the whole canvas up full of mountains. Which is okay. It's a super way of to practice this. I'm going to take a 2-inch brush and just tap.
I don't know. I'm bored, guys. I'm sorry.
Very gently lift upward. Upward, upward, over here. Still following those angles. Some blue. It blues right here. And we let it go right on through. Something about like it.
Let's take a look at how we did. Oh wow, I like it. It really shows the character of it all. Okay. Well, I'm signing off. See ya.